Holy shit, Apple, you actually did it. Literally 5 minutes ago, Apple Newsroom comes out with the announcement of Final Cut Pro and Logic Pro for the iPad. Something that people have asked for so long, and I myself was completely convinced that this was not going to happen. Anytime they've been pushing like Pro apps for the iPad, it's been DaVinci Resolve. And to me, it feels like very interesting timing. But yeah, let me run through the news on this, which by the way, if you're wondering about the crazy look, Sue Ray just sent me the anamorphic 35 millimeter for the Ronin 4D. So this is true anamorphic on a Ronin 4D. How's it look? So yeah, Apple brings Final Cut and Logic Pro to the iPad. You can see a little preview of them there. It looks quite interesting because it looks like more or less the traditional layouts. I am not a Logic expert. I'm not gonna have too much opinions on that besides like, oh, that looks cool. But let's jump through Final Cut here. So important notes here, it will be available on the App Store May 23rd. So we have a couple weeks. Don't run to the App Store like I did and try searching it because you won't find it. We get a nice little demo here.
Wow. This is insane.
It's really cool because it automatically animates, so I didn't have to put in hours of work to do it.
You can film it straight into the...
All right, so key takeaways from that video is it looks like your playhead is going to be a very interesting toggling type thing on the right-hand side. It looks like they're really promoting the keying feature, and I think they're using the same technology from almost like using depth map and stuff from, you know, on the iPhone, how you can like press and hold now on a subject and it will like automatically cut it out and you can drag it to like another, you know, your notes or something to paste it or a message. It looks like the same keying technology and process where you'll be able to very quickly key out subjects and they look like pretty clean mats, but obviously we'll see how it works in real world. But the most standout feature and what is making me go like, bah, Apple Pencil integration into it. That absolutely is currently not in any other NLE. Can't find that in DaVinci Resolve. Definitely not gonna find that in like LumaFusion or iMovie, but looks like that is going to be next level for motion graphics because not only can you draw with all your normal pen tools, but then it showed how you can do basic animations. Towards the end, it looks like they were even like keying it with different layers to have like subjects go in between the letters and I don't know, some crazy motion graphic stuff going on there. That looks incredible. So it looks like this very interesting tool that's gonna be on the right hand side. Definitely they have optimized the UI for iPad and specifically for touch. A lot of these demos, they're not even using a keyboard, which is really cool because for DaVinci Resolve, while it is optimized for the iPad and it is for touch, maybe not relies, but it's still very useful to have the keyboard. And in my course, I get tons of messages of people asking about like, oh, like how do I use this without the keyboard? And you can, but this looks like it's really made for, okay, you get some multi-cam stuff going. It looks like they've really done a good job at bringing over the simplicity that Final Cut has. You can see there's not much going on in this user interface on the screen. Well, hey, now, what is this? I don't know if this is within the Final Cut app or if this is, do you already have this in the camera app? No, right? No, that is very much a new pro camera app that has white balance and looks like some other buttons that I'm curious what it does. Doesn't allude to like an update to the camera app. Maybe it has a new pro camera app within the app itself. Yeah, so here's the fast cut features with machine learning, removal masks, auto crop, voice isolation. That'll be interesting to compare to DaVinci Resolve's. So it looks like we'll get some good graphics packs in there. I wonder if motion VFX app will work. Here we go. You can import and export projects. So this will be compatible with Final Cut Pro for the desktop. That's good. Because that would have been a huge miss if not. And Logic Pro for the iPad, this looks sweet. I mean, I'm sure audio files will be nerding out. It looks definitely more intense than just the basic like GarageBand for iPad. So I'm happy audio pros will get something out of it. And yeah, down here at the bottom, we have pricing and availability. So Tuesday, May 23rd, Will be available on the App Store. So Final Cut Pro and Logic Pro will be on the App Store for $5 a month or $50 per year with a 1 month free trial. Interesting. Final Cut has always been in the same boat as Resolve, where it's been a one-time payment and then you own it. Resolve for the iPad is the same way. I think it's $99 or whatever, or $90, and then you just own it, all future updates. This, while it definitely is not a bad price, especially for what you get, and I think a million creators, Final Cut lovers will pay that in a heartbeat. I know I will, because it's my job to test this stuff out. But it is interesting that it's a subscription model, so it doesn't look like there's currently an option to just buy it once and then own it. So let me know what you guys think about that in the comments below. What do you think about overall this announcement? Good job, Apple. I guess you haven't totally let the pros down. It's good to see you still have that team put together.